So I'm debating back and forth, right? I've been sitting here staring at the rattlesnakes. I have these set up for them. I'm ready to move them. Clearly this one's ready to get moved. But I'm debating back and forth whether I want to put them in this cage right here, or I have 2 4-foot by 2-foot cages that I could actually set them up in right now. So I don't know, they're kind of small for these cages right now. And then these cages work. I'm just debating, I'm going back and forth. So while I'm debating, I'm gonna move my yellowtail Cribo into here and then put my blacktail Cribo into that bigger cage for now. Damn, but I'm gonna set, see, now if I do this, right, it'll change because I won't be able to put both the rattlesnakes in these 4x2 cages. I'll only be able to do one. This is just, I'm going back and forth, so I might just be moving stuff right now for no reason. We're gonna find out. But I already got this cage clean. Charles Manson actually used to be in this cage. So this was a blacktail Cribo. And right now he just shed, he's in the rack right now. I just moved him because I'm switching some things around. And this yellowtail Cribo, yellow wolf, is about to have a new home in this big bullfile cage, which is cool. Because the yellowtail Cribo has been in a rack this whole time. So you can see the snake room's looking more dialed right now, right? Like I got things moved around. I pulled one of these vision cages off and I took Mochi off. She was in a bin up on here. And I'm gonna set her up in a cage tomorrow. I'm gonna go to the store, get some substrate for her. I already got her tank set up, the vision cage, same size as this one, with a heat lamp on it. So she'll have a nice lamp. We're gonna set up a cool, realistic looking setup for her. So yeah, that's my only ball python right now, which is pretty damn cool. So she's gonna get to be out and enjoy the front room with everyone. She's actually going right on top of the bearded dragon, Captain, so you guys can see him when we go out there. We can probably just set up, do a video tomorrow setting that cage up, since it'll be a cool little realistic setup versus this paper. Right now she's on paper and been in a small Ziploc bin, one of these bins. So it's time to step it up for her. Honestly, the bins work great. I'm kind of, it's like bittersweet moving them into a cage, because the cage is going to be super cool for her. But the bin is so simple, you just line it with paper. It's like she sheds fine, she eats fine. It's hella easy to keep the humidity in it, the heat in it. It's super simple for the bin. So, whatever. Paper's probably extra loud in the microphone. And some water, right? You know what I'm saying? Sack on that real quick. And then we need a snake. We need snake and we need water bowl. Get you a high-end water bowl. Step your game up. Bam! I need a hook. Right? Yellowtail Cribo, his name is Yellow Wolf, is a Guyana locality. And a lot of people ask me, Yellowtail Cribo or Blacktail Cribo? And that is a very, very tough decision. It's a hard pick. I like the look of the yellowtails. I like how they pop. It has that wow factor, right? Color. The blacktail, I have more of them. So they tend to be better eaters for me. These eat everything, but my blacktails eat snake, especially after it crazy. These guys haven't eaten snake for me. I had to scent it with fish one time and then he ate a whole snake. And I guess he just wasn't used to holding something in so big, and he regurged that snake. So I got to clean up that mess, and I decided I'm not gonna feed him another snake other than a small one. He'll hold it down, but a very tough decision. So when it comes down to it, the blacktail, the look of them, they're more like formally badass, I guess you could say. It's like a dude in a suit who would whoop your ass is a blacktail. This one is like Artie the MMA looking fighter that's just gonna fuck you up, who's kind of rowdy. That's like this one. And then the blacktail is like in a tuxedo and just kicks your ass because you stepped on a shoe. You know what I mean? It's kind of like that. So I'd probably go with blacktail. Not for that reason, for it stepping on your shoe and whooping your ass in a suit, but just overall, I would probably choose the blacktail. I love both though, so you can't say. If you have a chance to get both, for sure get both. Look at that tail. I mean, that's insane. Yellow wolf. He's gonna look hella cool inside this bowfowl cage. So this is the biggest, he's upgrading. He wasn't the vision rack, which is a V70 rack. So it's like 1.5 foot by 3 foot tub. Like 6 inches high. This one a foot high, 2 foot deep, 4 foot wide. Decked out with FTL and Rude Boy stickers. Fuck, you can't go wrong with that, right? We gotta take this Charles Manson sticker off and swap that. But now we got a yellowtail Cribo in this bowfowl cage. We're fucking making moves here, people. Alright. So now I don't have enough substrate in here. And I actually need to get heat in here because there's no heat on this cage. And what we should do, what are we gonna do with the rattlesnakes? Fuck, this is tricky. This cage opens hella hard, so I don't wanna put the rattlesnake in it because I wanna be able to shut it. So that means I would have to swap these, but that means if I swap them, I need to take the sand out of this one, put it in, oh wait. No, because this one opens right. So this one opens good, so if I put this one on the bottom, then we just need to get a heat lamp for it, and I think I have a heat lamp. Then we could put a rattlesnake in the big one. If we do that. But then it's like, what do I do with these? This is so stupid. If I put the blacktail Cribo in there, I guess either way we should switch these. Okay, we'll be right back. I need some help switching these real quick. So, yeah, just like that, we're done.